Well, you see, the first time when I met ABBA, it was actually when some artist friends of them were performing at a big show restaurant in Stockholm. And so these artist friends, very famous Swedish artist, said, "I'm so satisfied with my costumes. Oh, we also like to try your designer." That was my first meeting with ABBA as a group. I had met them separately because Annefrid was performing in a theater in Stockholm, and I was also producing costumes for that theater. Because of the song title as Waterloo, I mean, it was so natural that it should be Napoleon. And Stikkan Andersson was also very involved in this, and he said, "Please, can we do it this way?" And I said, honestly, "We can do it any way you like it," because I was completely overcrowded with other kind of artist production by that time. And I said, well, we can do something really very, very strange. So that's the way it came out. So I can really admit that that was the most unplanned ABBA outfit that we ever, ever produced for them. Annefrid has always been interested in costumes, in outfits, and she still is. Agneta also wanted to have her own personal touch, and sometimes the boys said, "Well, as long as we can match it, we can go on stage with it." But they were all taking part with it, and were always discussions before a production went on stage. This is the outfit that Agneta was wearing at just the start of their career. You know, that was the time when the outfit, the costume, got more attention than the song. And that was, I think, the only time that Stikkan Andersson wasn't really satisfied with my work. Because writing more about Agneta's famous bottom, for the first time presented in a complete stretch leotard tricot outfit, and but I loved it, I must say, I loved it. And I think we have lots of pop groups that has copied this type of costume after. And that's nice. What amazed me a little bit is that the outfit that Annefrid was wearing didn't draw that much attention. Because Litt's little miniskirt by that time was a sensation, or should have been, I think. Because it was just bits and pieces and could open like this. And I'm surprised that there wasn't a question, and what was she wearing under? Because every time she moved, it flipped open like this. And that, I think, would have been a sensation. But obviously, it wasn't. Money, 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 must be funny in the rich man's world. For some tours, I also get inspired by different nations' costumes. For example, this one was exclusively produced just for the Japanese tour. And of course you can see this was a celebration to the Japanese people. We were using some of the designs of the classical Japanese kimono style. And so the whole costume was hand-painted and decorated with rhinestones and crystals. Each and single one is put there. So they got their own color, of course, the green one, to match marvelously red hair of Annefrid. This one is the only one who has a decoration on its back, because Benny was presented mostly from the backside, and you can also see his sleeve hadn't a classical Japanese flag style, as I used to call it, because he couldn't play with that, so we had to make it a little bit shorter. And this is Björn's. And a funny thing about these costumes is that we wanted to produce them for stage so they could be lightened in different ways. If you look at this costume, if I hold this up and I put that sleeve over that shoulder, it's easier when there's somebody in the costume, and I take the other one over here, I make the costume completely white. All the decorations all of a sudden disappear. Now you can turn the costume red or blue or whatever you want to. But if you open up and you make it that way, put it to the side and you open up the inside, you get the full effect of the decoration. That's also a typical Japanese tradition that I've been studying in Japanese very old imperial costumes. You can dance, you can dance. I didn't travel with the costumes because I didn't have the time. So I had to stay home, unfortunately. But many of the tours, I was just from the beginning of the tour, I started the whole thing and then left everything over to wardrobe people. I mean, some of the tours were fully equipped with two or three or even four samples of each costume, so they could be shifted, they were identical, and they could be cleaned and transported to the next place. Although ABBA was performing in the first outfit on the first place. So when they came to the second place, that was the next costume, and so it went up. It was the same thing with the stage, with the lighting, with everything. It was a huge tour. And so exactly to say how many, because we also had the band, because I designed for all the band and for the chorus girls and boys, so it could be up to a few hundred costumes going on tour. So, for the Chiquitita, for Fernando and all of these productions and tours, we made Spanish, South American, Latin, Mexican-inspired costumes. Well, to be honest, almost every tour was special design. I mean, the last tour, you know, with the tricots and the leotards that really exposed their bodies in the most fantastic way. I loved it. And if you could see all these colors on the costumes, they were just like reflections of the northern light in the sky and reflecting in the ice mountains and a frozen Swedish lake. So you got all the blue, lilac, light blue, dark blue, and silver and white types of colors mixed together. And, you know, also the design, the polar design behind them were two huge mountains of ice, and they had the same color. And if you eventually remember the opening of that show, the two girls had the two huge capes that they were wearing. They are too big to bring in here right now. And they were turned the other way down. So at a distance, you could get the impression that these were the ice mountain reflections, the images of those two polar mountains in the background. So yes, everything was specially designed. One that I really love is Thank You for the Music, that song I really love, because that's what I love to say every time when I listen to it. Thank you for the music. Thank you for the experience. Thank you, all four of the ABBA members, being so generous, being so close together. It was almost always thank you for the costume. And I think that was something great, really.